friends, in this video I am going to discuss about aptitude and the foundational values of civil service. So here, what is meant by aptitude? Capability for doing a particular work or solve a problem. It is also the capability of a person certain task at certain level. It may be talent but not knowledge or understanding or learned or acquired abilities or the skill or attitude. So it means, it does not mean acquired or learned abilities, and at the same time in some extent skills are inherent, so it can be acquired also. It is contrast to knowledge acquired from learning. For example, law and order. So law and order maintained by police or CBI requires different skills in case of investigation. And if you take, the aptitude can be learned and upgraded through proper training and capacity building. Next, move on to civil service values in India. So an essential part of the government. So it supports the government to develop and implement the policies. It can create accountability from civil servants to minister and ministers to parliament. Parliament in the sense Rajya Sabha and Lok Sabha. And civil servants are selected on the merit basis in the form of fair and open competition, with dedication and commitment towards the job, and they also test their core values like integrity, honesty, objectivity and impartiality. There are mainly six civil service values are mentioned in ethical form. One is impartiality, second one is objectivity, third openness, fourth responsibility, fifth service principle, and sixth one is reliability of administrative operations. In this video I am going to discuss about what is meant by integrity core value. So let's begin with integrity. It's fundamental moral concept. It is also closely related to ethics. So it is associated with the value of being honest and maintain strong moral value. It has divided into three main, like financial integrity, professional integrity and intellectual integrity. If you take this, integrity is a person. If the person is holding the integrity, then he have more moral values. For example, during interview, IAS interview also, they test the person of a particular person, and they test particular the sense integrity. Okay, so what you answer towards the judge, so they judge in front of in the sense of the integrity from your answers. Okay, so it may be given some moral stand on conflicts or the some kind of issues. For example, weaker session people, how they are going to develop their life, how the poverty to be reduced in India. So this kind of moral conflict situations to be given, and you have to give the answer. And the second one, annual performance report submitted by all government servants every year, that is APR. Okay, such a net about annual performance report, it is very important. And consider a person with integrity who stand up for best judgment. So whatever else the situation is, worst or best, so they taken the best judgment and emphasizes the wholeness and intactment of moral stand. It is a virtue in that they see the accountable moral responsibility as necessary tool for maintaining church consistency. It is given by Halfman in 1989. In terms of the person's dedication to the pursuit of a moral life and their intellectual responsibility in seeking to understand the demands of such life. The main types of integrity. Previously we discussed about three. Now we are discussing about two types, that is personal integrity and institutional integrity. Under the personal integrity, we can accountability for personal actions and relations. But in the case of the institutional integrity, we can focus on vision and mission of an organization. Okay, next move on to institutional integrity, professional code. It is about fostering the ethical behavior throughout an institutions through personal integrity. Example, management practice and ethical training. Here, integrity approach is value-based. It's rule-based. So, the value-driven instead of rule-driven. And in the decision-making process done via incentives, leaders, education, training, action and behavior. There are four steps involved in integrity. That is, one, keeping in mind the purpose of one's action and acting consistently with the choice. It may be inconvenient or unprofitable, doesn't mind. So, on the purpose. And second, choosing right course of conduct in conformity with moral principles, that is code of ethics. Okay, code of ethics, code of conduct also. So, openly declared one's intention or where one stands. So, what is your stand? You have to declare. And fourth, final one, that is the results of one's action. So, in this topic, I discuss about integrity not much. So, if you take some questions related to integrity, like explain the term integrity for civil servants in the aspect of personal and professional. Second, if you take one of the tests of integrity is complete refusal to be compromised. Explain with reference to a real life example. So you have to give the integrity. So what is the definition and what is the process involved, what is the model of integrity, and you have to give some example. So I mentioned two examples, that is one from Nelson Mandela. He arrested for 27 years at jail for overthrowing apartheid, okay, in Africa. And second, if you take Gandhi in India, he taken the fast until death or die concept during independence. Okay, so he does not reduce their integrity in the sense of completing their task. Okay, next, take the quotes related to integrity. I mentioned only two quotes. If you want, you can take more quotes also. So, I taken only two quotes from Ralph Waldo Emerson and Confucius. So, here, nothing is at last sacred but the integrity of your own mind. That is given by Ralph Waldo Emerson. And second, the strength of a nation derives from the integrity of the home, given by Confucius. So, I completed the topic. Thank you, friends.